Sparta Public Works Committee meeting Thursday, June 24th, 2010. Roll call, Madam Secretary.
Yes, sir. Mr. Andrew Pont?
Here.
Mr. Brain?
Here.
Mr. Collins?
Here.
Mr. Farnum?
Here.
Mrs. Griffin?
Present.
President Guidry?
Here.
Mr. Landry?
Here.
Dr. Mackey?
Present.
Mr. McMillan?
Here.
Mr. Scott?
Here.
Mr. Spell?
Here.
Mr. Stelly?
Here.
Mr. Sias?
Present.
Mrs. Trimmie was unable to attend this evening for medical reasons, and Chairman Hassan?
Here.
You do have a quorum.
Thank you. Item number three, presentation of a proclamation to Mr. Mike White proclaiming Friday, June 25th, 2010 as Mike White Day in Calcasieu Parish in honor of his extraordinary career as a world champion bull rider. Mr. McMillan.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Mike, if I can get you to come on up here with me. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm proud to introduce to y'all one of the true superstars of Southwest Louisiana. I don't know if y'all, like me, ever watch Versus on Sunday night and watch the PBR and watch the bull riding, but this is one of the best bull riders out there. Mike is going to retire this weekend at Burton Coliseum. He's come back home. Mike's from Moss Bluff, and he's come back home to actually retire here. He's going to ride his last two bulls here at Burton Coliseum Friday night and Saturday night. It's a challenge event against a world champion, two-time world champion, Chris Shivers. And Mike promises us he's going to beat Chris Shivers on his home court right here. I think right now we have a little video that they may have put together. And we're going to watch this real quick, and then I'll read the proclamation, and then we'll hear from Mike. That last bull he was riding there was Troubadour, and that was his best ride ever at 95 and three quarters. And that's a ride that a lot of people in the PBR think it's a history-making ride. It's one of the best rides ever in the PBR. I can tell you that in that video, you saw him get off the ground and fall or get off the bull real easy. There's been a number of times that he didn't get off the bull so easy. I think he's had broke his neck a couple of times and was out for an extended period of time. He's had a number of injuries. You know, when you get off the bulls, they come after you, and that's kind of one of those things. With that being said, I'm going to read the proclamation, then we're going to hear a few words from Mike. Proclamation says, whereas, since first getting on a bull at age 15, Mike White, a native of Moss Bluff, Louisiana, has been at the top of his game. Whereas Mike White turned pro in 1997, and almost 50 bull riding titles on his resume, been named PBR Rookie of the Year in 1999, whereas Mike White was declared World Champion Bull Rider, Professional Rodeo Association, that's the PRCA, in 1999, whereas the Savvy Veteran was among the top 10 in the world during the 2008, and four finishes in the top five and nine into the top 10, and perhaps the most exhilarating ride in PBR history with a score of 95.75 aboard Troubadour. And whereas, although his career will soon come to a close, Mike White will forever be remembered for his great success and remarkable talent as a bull riding champion. Therefore, Kevin Guidry, president of the police juror of Calcasieu Parish in the sovereign state of Louisiana, does proclaim Friday, tomorrow, June 25th, to be Mike White Day in Calcasieu Parish. Mike, congratulations. Tomorrow's your day.
Thank you. I don't know who made that video, but they did a heck of a job. They didn't put any on there that I was falling off of, so that was great. Because I know there's lots of them that I do fall off of. I want to thank everybody for recognizing this. And, you know, even though I don't live here anymore, I still feel like this is home to me. Got so many friends and family that are still here and love to come back down here. I still have a friend that takes care. I've got 50 head of cows still here at Calcasieu Parish, and I still make it down here four times a year. And I do miss this place even though I'm not here. And hopefully, I don't really know much about Mike White Day, but hopefully I can go get a car from Billy Navarre and speed around town and not get in trouble. I don't know, is that going to be legal, Hal?
We'll take care of that.
But I do appreciate it, and thank y'all very much.
I would like to close. I want to get a picture with him with the plaque, but I would like to close in saying that he's having the first, what we hope will be the first annual Mike White Invitational out at Burton Coliseum Friday night and Saturday night. And we're looking for a capacity crowd. I believe it's going to sell out. We've got a bunch of the top PBR riders coming over, some of the best bulls coming over for his Mike White Invitational. This is an economic boost for Calcasieu Parish to have an event like this at Burton Coliseum, and this is the first, so get out and support it so it can be a yearly thing. I'm hoping that you're intending on having this every year. I'll let you say, let me let him say a little bit about the event, and I see Mr. Sias okay. would like to have a question.
If all goes well, that it will be an annual event. You know, the PBR has struggled at this level events. This is a non-televised event, but it is a enterprise event, meaning we added $12,000 in prize money for the bull riders. And a lot of bull riders that are on the televised series don't like to come to these events and take the chance of getting hurt when they're riding for $100,000 on the weekend. But they've a lot of the top bull riders have came to this event this weekend, and they will be here, and I'm honored for them to come. And we also selected some of the greatest bulls that everybody sees on TV every weekend. I know none of y'all are going to be familiar with the bulls, but we have a bull called Bones. He's the world champion bucking bull in 08. We have another bull called Uncle Buck. He's in the running for the bucking bull of the year this year. This bull's been ridden once in his career so far. He's really a rank bull. We got another bull, Deja Blue. All these bulls will be in the short round. And the guys, what we do is there's 40 bull riders each night. The top 10 guys will come back for the short round each night. And they will get a chance to select their short round bull. So it'll be interesting to see which cowboys step up and take which bulls that they feel like they can win on. So it's going to be a great event, and hopefully we'll see some of y'all there. But I didn't even know what bulls they had selected. Me and Chris are going to have a match bull riding for my last bull ride. And what we done was selected two bulls. He'll get on one Friday, and I'll get on one Friday, and then we'll swap those bulls on Saturday. So it'll be an honest match, bull against bull, to see who can outride who, and I'm going to win.
Yes, sir.
President Guidry.
Thank you, Mr. Chair. Mike, it was really a pleasure having you on the show, man.
I appreciate it. Enjoyed it.
Some of the things that a lot of you guys wasn't aware of that we discussed, I told one of the guys here on the jury, it's a competition going on between Hal and I, So I asked Mike, what would be the legal time? I know it's 8 minutes that you've got to ride a bull to make it eight seconds. And I said, could we break it down to four between Hal and I? And he said, well, Kevin, you know there's two bulls that's coming in from Texas. And he said, now you and Hal could have the choice of those bulls. And he gave me the name of them. I remember the name of the one that I would probably be riding, his name is Lassie. The one that Hal would be riding, it's Satan's firstborn. So for those of you that really wasn't thinking about coming out, guys, I promise you it's going to be an event. Come out and see the fireworks, I promise you. But, Mike, we applaud what you're doing here in Southwest Louisiana, man, and ever there's anything we can do as a governing body to forward any kind of progress on what you're doing, please let us know, man. And again, congratulations, man.
Thank you, and I appreciate y'all recognizing it.
Yes, Mr. Sias?
Oh, no, I just wanted to say congratulations for what you all have done. And I want to ask you a question. You don't have any videos of you doing what that matador did when he took off running in the police when that bull came out to him, huh?
No, sir. No, sir. When my ride's over, I get far as away as I can.
Thank you, Mr. Sias.
Nancy McCluskey, who's with the event, says already, you know, from the riders coming in, there's been over 90 hotel rooms sold out. There'll be a really big economic boost to the community. And one of these things, too, all these great riders after the rodeo, after bull riding, they're going to be at LeBaire's signing autographs and taking pictures with the kids. So this is going to be a big event for Southwest Louisiana and something we want to see continue.
We still have some more, Hal?
He's talking about the economical boost. But what we have at this level, too, is what they call a classic and futurity level. A lot of the bulls that will be here this weekend, a classic level is 3- and 4-year-old bulls. These guys give an amount of money for these bulls. They sell anywhere from $300,000 to $10,000, and they buy these bulls to have competition. The stock contractors are paying $1,250 to have their bull in this competition. And these guys that's got a lot of money and travel around the world hauling their bulls around, saying my bull's better than yours. So these bulls are in competition too. So there's probably about 70 of these guys here this weekend, stock contractors that's bringing these bulls around the country and competing with them also. So
big money rodeo. We're glad to have you.
Hal, we have a few more jurors. Hal,
we're gonna take a picture here.
We want to take that picture. You're not getting away without that picture. You're gonna definitely take
Hal,
that
she
picture.
Wasn't gonna leave with the camera. Dr. Mackey.
I just wanted to say that just from a city boys aspect, you've got to have strong legs the way you twisted that bull around.
Thank you, Dr.
I jog a lot.
Mr. Landry.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. You know, I couldn't help but think when you and Hal, the last event y'all did was the basketball game, and y'all both came up here on crutches and had surgery.
You're right, Chris.
And there wasn't even a bull
We may
involved.
Both been a neck brace for this one, Chris.
Yeah, or a body cast. Exactly, if you would, just so it's clear, when is the event? Is it this weekend? Give us the dates and the times, if you would, and how could we buy tickets?
The event is Friday and Saturday at 7:30. The tickets go on sale at the Burton Coliseum tomorrow at noon. You can also buy tickets at Cotton's Western Wear, Moe's Western Wear, and Patton's Western Wear now. Tickets have been on sale at those locations probably for about the last month.
Okay. Thank you.
Yes, sir.
Mr. Landry. Mr. Spill.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Mike, just wanted to wish you congratulations on behalf of the people of Ward 1 and Calcasieu Parish for a great career. And the fact that you represent your community as a great competitor, we have the utmost appreciation for that and just wish you the best of luck and success. So thank you.
I appreciate it. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Spill. Mr. Andropont.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. You said you're competing against Chris. I just want to make sure we're not competing against this Chris.
No.
Because if you are, my money's on you.
Yeah. I assure you, it's not me. Any other drawers? Thank you.
Thank y'all.
Item number 4, consideration of making a recommendation with reference to adopting a resolution authorizing the president of the police jury to execute the
Move
necessary
on four.
Documents. Second. For acquisition of right-of-way from Coastal Plain Conservancy on Corbino Road in Ward 3. We have a motion and a second. Any discussion? Any objection? Hearing none, motion carried. Item number five, consideration
move
of
on five.
Making a recommendation with reference to adopting a resolution authorizing the president of the police jury to execute the necessary documents for donation of right-of-way from Joseph Reed, Christina Marie Myrick, Gloria McCoy Johnson, Warren David Nichols, and Jessica Lynn Roberts Nichols on Reed Road in Ward 1. We have a motion by Mr. Stelly, a second by Mr. Spell. Any discussion? Any objection? Hearing none, motion carries. Item number six, consideration of making a recommendation with reference to adopting a resolution authorizing the Division of Engineering and Public Works to send a letter to the Louisiana Department of Transportation and Development requesting that consideration be given to the priority order shown for various railroad crossings within Calcasieu Parish for the installation of signal devices under the Highway Safety Program 203. We have a motion by Mr. Sias, a second by Ms. Griffin. Any discussion? Any objection? Hearing none, motion carries. Item number seven, consideration of making a recommendation with reference to adopting an ordinance amending the Code of Ordinances of Calcasieu Parish, Louisiana, to include the following schools and or to change the physical address of schools as noted. Mr. Vickers.
Mr. Chairman, we'd like to defer this agenda item to the regular agenda at our next meeting. We could. We need to work on the wording on this just a little bit.
Okay, I would move to defer that.
Second.
We have a second by Mr. Antipon. You second that. Motion and a second to defer. Any discussion? Any objection? Hearing none, motion carries. I'll entertain a motion to adjourn.
Move.
Meeting adjourned.
We will now call the agenda committee meeting to order for Thursday, June 24th, 2010. The purpose of today's committee meeting is to formulate an agenda for the regular meeting of the police jury July 1st, 2010. The proposed agenda follows. I need a motion to pull items 19 through 31.
Second.
A motion to second to pull 19 through 31. Are there any other items that need to be pulled at this time? To item 19, to take appropriate action to fill a vacancy created by the resignation of Mr. Larry.
Move to defer until July 1st. And Mr. Remy.
Second.
I have a motion by Mr. Landry to defer and a second by Ms. Griffin. Any discussion? Any opposition? Motion carries. Number 20, take appropriate action to fill a vacancy created by the resignation of Mr.
Move to defer for 30 days.
Second.
To defer?
Yes, sir.
We have a motion to defer with a second. Is any discussion? Any opposition? Motion carries. 21, take appropriate action on the expiration of the term of Mr. Dennis
Scott.
Move
to reappoint.
Second.
I have a motion to reappoint with a second. Do we have any discussion? Any opposition? Mr. Scott is hereby reappointed. 22, take appropriate action on the expiration
move
of the term
22.
Of Mr.
Second.
Thomas Shields. What was the motion?
Reappoint.
We have a motion to reappoint. Do I have a second?
Second.
Second by Mr. Sias. Any discussion? Any opposition? Motion carries. 23, take appropriate action on the expiration term of Ms. Bridget Martin as a member of the Burton Collison Advisory Council. The motion to reappoint with a second. Any discussion? Any opposition? Motion carries. 24, take appropriate action on the expiration of the term of Mr.
Second.
Joseph Laverne as a member of the Burton Collison Advisory Board. We have a motion to reappoint.
No.
Sorry. McNeese is asking that Mr. Braylon L. Harris be appointed. Any discussion? Do we have a motion?
Yes, sir.
We have a motion and a second that Mr. Harris be appointed at recommendation of McNeese State University. Any discussion? Any opposition? Motion carries. 25. Take appropriate action on the expiration of the term of Mr. Michael Othman as a member of the board.
Michael.
Have a motion to reappoint Mr. Othman. Do we have a second?
Second.
Have a second. Any discussion? Any opposition? Motion carries. 26. Take appropriate action on the expiration term to Mr. James Holloway. We have a motion to defer.
To the regular meeting.
To the regular meeting.
Do we have any discussion? Any opposition? Motion carries. 27.
Move to reappoint.
Have a motion on the floor to reappoint Ms. Cindy Copenhagen as a member of the Board of Commissioners of the Community Center and Playground District Number 4 of Ward 1. Is any discussion? Any opposition? Motion carries. 28. Take appropriate action on the expiration term of Mr. Terry Burns as a member of the Board of Commissioners of the Community Center and Playground District Number 3 of Ward 7. We have a motion to reappoint with a second. Any discussion? Any opposition? Motion carries. 29.
Move to defer till next meeting.
Second.
For the record, the expiration of term of Mrs. Danny Joyce Markentel. I have a motion to defer till the next meeting. With a second, any discussion? Any opposition? Motion carries. Number 30, take appropriate action.
Move to reappoint.
Second.
Expiration of the term of Mr. James Gilbo as a member of the Board of Commissioners of the Community Center Playground District Number 2, Ward 4. We have a motion and a second. Any discussion? Any opposition? Motion carries. 31. Take appropriate action on the expiration of the term of Mr. Alan Carter, member of the Board of Commissioners, Water Works District Number 12 of Ward 3. Mr. Brayman, Mr. Liaison.
Move
Scott
to defer.
Liaison.
I haven't spoke with him, so we can defer till the next meeting.
All right, we have a motion to defer. With a second, with any discussion? Any opposition? Motion carries. Do I have a motion to adjourn?
Motion to adjourn.
Meeting is hereby adjourned.